Hi friends, just thought I'd do another update. Yes, today thought I might just talk a bit about whatever comes to mind. Of course, I've been thinking about the Light Brothers, or the Brothers of Light from the Emerald Tablets. Of course, you've got all the different religions of the world. They're all, mainly all of them, keep saying about keep your face ever towards the light. You know, the light of the world. Obviously, sun, the Jesus, Krishna, Buddha, Muhammad, of course not the radical version, but the true version. All these are about the true light in everyone. And the way that we get this light is quite simple, but people have lost the knowledge through the years. So I thought I might try and just give a brief overview of how it may be attained inside everyone is a soul. And the soul is made by God, or it's from God. Some people, I heard on a podcast the other day, some people actually believe that it could even be angels incarnating into people in some extreme cases. They've been obviously people that have been put under and thinking, oh, I want to see what my last life was, but only finding out that their last life wasn't human life, it was an angelic life. So there's quite a few different elements there, friends, that people could in fact go with. Sorry, I'm just going to get my cup of tea. Here we go. So, how do we attain the knowledge or the light? I have explained this before in other videos. My meditation videos are the ones that I mention it in. First of all, the light, it comes straight from God, like I say, the spirit. Everyone thinks that spirit is separate. Of course it is, but you can actually access it yourself. When you go to sleep at night time, you access it directly. Sometimes when you dream, you don't always dream. It could be you're going back to where you previously existed in another realm. Maybe you were a spirit and then reborn. Or maybe you're visiting loved ones that are on that other side. Of course, you have to be careful. Some cases, bad entities can come through. This is why it's so important to protect yourself, protect your home with magic. Now, the way you do it is quite simple. Sometimes you don't even have to use a spell. Just the thought of protecting your home. An action so simple as getting some salt and putting it in the corners of the house or in the sprinkling it in, let's say, the front of your path, the back of your house, going from corner to corner. It doesn't even have to be in the house, it can be outside. Draw sticks are good, the smoke, anything that cleanses is very good, keeps negative energy away. Of course, when you do your meditation or when you want this light to come in, close your eyes. Try and think of nothing. Imagine seeing a light in the distance. Let it come very close to you slowly. It's like a flashlight in the distance. Someone's holding it and it's coming closer and closer to your face until there's nothing there. It's just light in front of your face. Some people don't go all the way with it. They just like bathing in the light. And that itself gives you energy. It's been proven that it actually helps lower cancer cells, kills cancer cells. The melatonin that flows from the brain kills cancer cells. And eventually, you get easier at doing it, better at doing it, until you don't need to even meditate anymore. I can just close my eyes and imagine I want the light there, open my eyes, and I can speak to spirits at will. Or have the light cleanse a person or cleanse a house or heal. I've healed people before. So I hope that this little introduction or overview helps people. We aren't alone in this universe, friends. But we can do a lot. Once you know your power is in knowledge and light, keep your face ever toward the light. Until next time, friends.